Hello friends, my name is Vikas. So friends, in this video we will be talking about some of the most important current affairs of the topic National Affairs of November month. This video will be very helpful to you, so do watch the video till the end. So friends, we'll start with our session, but before that we have something important to tell you about. So students, we have an app by the name Careers Cloud which you can go and download using the Play Store, and it is available only for the Android users as of now. Once you have downloaded and opened the app, you will see a page such as the second screen here. Then you just need to log in with your Google ID or you can say with your Gmail ID on this application, and once you have logged in, you are ready to use the particular application. As you can see, you will be seeing here My Course, All Courses, Crack Current Affairs. Just click on any of those and you will be directed to a second page. Here now, what are the features or why we recommend you to use the app? Because on the app, we provide you daily current affairs, both in English as well as in Hindi. Both Hindi and English current affairs are provided you daily along with the quiz sessions. This is important. We provide you daily with the quiz sessions that will help you to brush up your current affairs that you gain today through our video or any other notes provided. These English and Hindi PDFs are also provided to you daily. This is provided on our app course that you can go and purchase. Two types of courses are there, 1 year plan and a second year plan, which you can opt as per your need. Then we provide you with weekly videos. Not just weekly videos on YouTube and monthly videos, daily videos are also given. Apart from that, weekly PDFs of current affairs are provided to you. Compiled PDF of current affairs of the whole week will be provided to you, both in English as well as in Hindi. Then similarly, for the month also, you will be provided a compiled video of the whole month, both in English as well as in Hindi. PDF for the current affairs that will brush up your current affairs very much. Apart from this, we provide you with the topic wise current affairs, topics such as apps and web portals, important days, books and authors, then comes your sports, then comes your obituary, national affairs, international affairs, sports. These all topics are covered by us on our YouTube channel, which you can go and check it out also. Very important this section, because we provide you with the PDFs also with them that helps you to revise through a particular order, and it is very helpful to you, so you should definitely check it out. Then apart from it, we provide you questions regarding your particular exams also, such as bank, related to your banking. We provide you questions, we provide you PDF, we provide you material that will help you to revise those topics, those important topics. So very important. Alright, so I definitely recommend you to check our app and do revise and to purchase the courses, because they will be very helpful to you. These, I strongly recommend you to use our app as well as website, and the quiz provided on the app is very helpful to you on the daily basis, and our monthly study material for your exams will do wonders. So do watch the video for the revision purposes. They are very helpful. And if you use my code VIKAS10, straight away you will be getting an additional 10% discount on the purchase you made using the application. So additional discount for you students, just from my side. It is a happy hour sale, you can say. 10% discount using VIKAS10. So friends, let's start with our session now. So friends, let's start. First is Samudriyan. Samudriyan was India's first and unique manned ocean mission that was launched at Chennai port. And who launched it? It was launched by Dr. Jitendra Singh. I repeat, name of the mission, Samudriyan. What it is? It is India's first unique manned mission, that is Samudriyan, launched by Minister of State Dr. Jitendra Singh at Chennai, that is in state of Tamil Nadu. Dr. Jitendra Singh, who has the independent charge of Ministry of Earth Science, has launched India's first manned mission, that is Samudriyan, from National Institute of Ocean Technology, that is NIOT, in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. With this launch, India joined the unique set of countries in the world like USA, Russia, Japan, France, China to have an underwater vehicle to carry out subsea missions. Then next thing important is Matsya 6000.
It is the manned submersible developed under India's deep sea mission. I repeat, it is the manned submersible that is developed under the India's deep sea mission that is currently developed with support of DRDO, ISRO and IIT Madras. So it's type of a machine that will go underwater for various explorations. So launched by NIOT Chennai Tamil Nadu, mission name is Samudriyan, launched by Dr. Jitendra Singh, or if ministry asks, Ministry of Earth Science, and it is India's first manned ocean mission. Next we'll be talking about Defense Minister Rajnath Singh has delivered keynote address at Indo-Pacific Regional Dialogue. Important thing about this Indo-Pacific Regional Dialogue is the theme that you should know. It is evolution in maritime strategy during the 21st century. Imperatives, challenges and way ahead. I repeat, theme you should know, mark this. This is more important in this. Theme being evolution in maritime strategy during the 21st century. Imperatives, challenges and way ahead. Next is your India's largest landfill, that is biogas plant, was launched in Hyderabad. Important, mark this or take a screenshot. Very important question. Question will be asked that where is India's largest landfill biogas plant situated? It is situated in Hyderabad. Ramki Enviro Engineers Limited, that is also known as REEL, has inaugurated one of the world's first and India's largest landfill gas to compressed biogas plant at Hyderabad. The end biogas product of the plant will be sold to Bhagyanagar Gas Limited. The main focus of this project is on the conservation of landfill gas into compressed gas on an automotive fuel. Next we'll be talking about 14th Urban Mobility Conference that was held and inaugurated by Hardeep Singh Puriji. I repeat, what was the edition of this mobility conference? It was the 14th edition of it, and it was inaugurated by whom? Inaugurated by the Minister of Housing and Urban Affairs, Hardeep Singh Puriji. We'll look at the data. Related ministry for this Urban Mobility India conference is Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas, along with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and their minister Hardeep Singh Puri virtually inaugurated the 14th edition of this Urban Mobility Conference 2021, and the theme also very important, so you should know, Mobility for All was the theme of this Urban Mobility India Conference. The objective of it was to provide equitable access to affordable, clean, safe, informative, efficient and accessible transport system for all the sections of the society, especially the specially abled women, elderly and children. If we talk about the 15th UMI conference, it will be held at Kochi, Kerala from 4th to 6th of November with the theme Azadi at 75 Sustainable Atmanirbhar Mobility. Hardeep Singh Puri presented 13 awards to the state city winners for excellence in urban transport. Next, we'll be talking about our Union Minister Amit Shah has launched Dairy Sahakar scheme from Anand, Gujarat. Question will be direct and simple, that Dairy Sahakar scheme was launched for which state? It was launched for Gujarat. Launched by whom? Our Union Minister Amit Shah launched this scheme. Next question. National Tribal Dance Festival is observed in which state? It is observed in Chhattisgarh. You should know, very important. The state of Chhattisgarh observed a 3-day long annual second National Tribal Dance Festival 2021 from 28th to 30th of October. It was held at Raipur Science College ground as a part of tourism development plan of the state. It was inaugurated by Chief Minister of Jharkhand Hemant Soren and Chief Minister of Chhattisgarh Bhupesh Baghel. Next question. IOC to set up India's first mega scale malic anhydride plant at Panipat, Haryana. Question will be direct, that IOC, that is your Indian Oil Corporation, is ready to set up India's first mega scale malic anhydride plant at what location? So location will be Panipat, Haryana. This is important here. Next, Government of India constituted 20 member EGOS to monitor implementation of PM Gati Shakti NMP. Now what is this? First of all, look at it. Gati Shakti Master Plan. The Prime Minister of India Narendra Damodar Das Modi launched PM Gati Shakti, that is National Master Plan for multimodal connectivity, during at an event at Pragati Maidan, New Delhi. As a part of this, it was announced that there will be empowered group of secretaries, that is EGOS, to look after the implementation of this program, that is Gati Shakti. So how many member committee will be this? This will be a 20 member committee. Next, Education Ministry launched Bhasha Sangam initiative for school mobile app and EBSB quiz app. What is EBSB? EBSB stands for Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat quiz application. So you should remember this. This is important. During the Rashtriya Ekta Divas, that is observed on 31st of October every year, that is the birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who was the first Deputy Prime Minister of India. On this Rashtriya Ekta Divas, that is 31st of October, recently Dharmendra Pradhanji, who is our Education Minister, has released three things. First is Bhasha Sangam initiative, second is Bhasha Sangam mobile application, and third becomes your Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat quiz application. So these three things were launched by our Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhanji during the Rashtriya Ekta Divas, that is observed on 31st of October, and in the memory of or on the birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, the first Deputy Prime Minister of India. Then our language is written in which, related to which schedule? It is related to 8 schedule. 22 languages are mentioned there, and this was an initiative of Ministry of Education launched under Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat, that is similarly to your Ek Bharat Shreshth Bharat quiz app. Next, Ayushman CAPF. Recently, our Home Minister Amit Shah has launched Pan India Health Card Scheme for CPPF, that is your Ayushman CAPF. It is to provide healthcare services to all CAPF personnel and their dependents, that is related to also their family members. Next, 5th Ganga Utsav, that is the river festival held virtually. Ganga Atlas developed by IIT Kanpur. Let's look at it. The annual Ganga Utsav 2021, that is the river festival, was virtually organized by National Missions for Clean Ganga, that is between 1st to 3rd November, to mark the anniversary of the announcement of River Ganga as the national river, that is on 4th of November. So Ganga Utsav or the river festival is organized by which organization? By National Mission for Clean Ganga. The year marked the 5th edition of the festival, which was celebrated under the leadership of Union Minister Gajendra Singh Shekhawat, who is the Ministry of Jal Shakti. As a part of ongoing celebration for 75 years of independence and Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, the minister launched the Ganga Atlas, River of the Past, developed by Professor Rajiv Sinha of IIT Kanpur of UP. If we talk about the National Mission for Clean Ganga, the mission for Clean Ganga under the Ministry of Jal Shakti is a society registered on 12th of August 2021 under the Societies Registration Act of 1860. It acts as an implementation arm of the National Ganga River Basin Authority. Next, and here is the aim, that is to clean Ganga and its tributaries. Next, DOT, that is Department of Telecommunications, formed a technology innovation group on 6G, chaired by K. Rajaraman, Telecom Secretary. Now, what is 6G? That is your internet related to your interstate C, just as 4G, 3G, 5G, and now 6G. So, Department of Telecommunications under the Ministry of Communication has confirmed a technology innovation group on the 6th generation 6G to take lead in the development of 6G technology globally. K. Rajaraman, the Chairman of Digital Communications Commission and Secretary, has been named the chairperson of the initiative. Technology Innovation Group is a 22-member group. If we talk about the aim, it is to create vision and objectives as well as develop a roadmap for research and development, pre-standardization, development of applications and products, and action plans for 6G technology. सेंटर लॉन्च्ड हर घर दस्तक अ कैंपेन टू इंक्रीज वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज. मनसुख मांडविया जी, हु इज द यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली अफेयर्स, हैज अनाउंस्ड दैट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज लॉन्च्ड हर घर दस्तक अ डोर टू डोर कोविड 19 वैक्सीनेशन कैंपेन टू इंक्रीज वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज अक्रॉस इंडिया. The campaign aims to motivate people towards getting fully vaccinated against the COVID-19 vaccine. UIDAI has launched Aadhaar Hackathon 2021 to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. Who launched it? It was launched by UIDAI. The Unique Identification Authority of India under the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology has organized a hackathon, that is Aadhaar Hackathon 2021, to celebrate Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav and promote the culture of innovation among youth. This is the first ever event conducted by the UIDAI. The objective of it will be to find innovative solutions to enhance the experience of the residents and to improve the interface of Aadhaar enrollment and authentication software platforms. If we talk about Aadhaar Hackathon 2021 was held from 28th October to 31st of October 2021. More than 5,000 innovators from across India participated in the 95 hours Aadhaar Hackathon 2021. Next is your Logistics Performance Index of Leads, in which Gujarat has retained the top slot. Important, which state topped in the Logistic Performance Index that was released by Leads? Or it was your Sir Gujarat. Gujarat has retained the top position in the top performer among 21 states in the leads, that is Logistic Ease Across Different States 2021 index, followed by Haryana, Punjab and Tamil Nadu. If we talk about the category here, in the states category it was taught by Gujarat. In the northeastern and states of Himalayan and Union Territories, it was taught by Jammu and Kashmir. And simply if we are talking about Union Territories, then it was taught by Delhi. Next is, Srinagar has joined the UNESCO's Creative Cities Network for the year 2021. Very important question, mark it. Recently, which city joined the UNESCO's Creative Cities Network 2021? It is your Srinagar. On 8th of November, the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization selected India, Srinagar city, a capital of Jammu and Kashmir, as one of the 49 cities selected under UNESCO Creative Cities Network for 2021. Srinagar became the 6th Indian city to receive this recognition. What are the other 6 cities, such as Hyderabad for gastronomy, Mumbai for film, Chennai for creative city of music, Varanasi for creative city of music, Jaipur for crafts and fox? Srinagar is selected under the craft and fox category. You should also know this. Alright, so Srinagar is selected under craft and fox art category. Next is DRDO Israel signs innovation agreement for dual use technology. On 9th of November, India's Defense Research and Development Organization, that is DRDO, signed a bilateral innovation agreement with Directorate of Defense Research and Development under the Ministry of Defense Israel to promote innovation and research in development of dual-use technologies by startup and micro, small and medium enterprises from both the countries. Next, India's first center for research on drone technology launched in IIT Guwahati. Very important, mark this. India's first center for research on drone technology was launched in IIT Guwahati. Union Minister of State Civil Aviation General V.K. Singh launched India's first center for excellence in research on drone UAV, that is unmanned air vehicle technology and artificial intelligence, at the Indian Institute of Technology Guwahati, Assam. V.K. Singh inaugurated the Skill Development Center for Drone UAV Operation and Maintenance and a nodal center for overall administration drone data management for the northeastern region. AXOM drone ports was also launched to support cargo drones that are delivering urgent medicinal and emergency supplies to remote areas of the region. Next, Indian Navy hosted third edition of Goa Maritime Conclave 2021. The Indian Navy has conducted the third Goa Maritime Conclave 2021 from 7th to 9th of November under the aegis of Naval War College, Goa. The GMC is an outreach initiative of the Indian Navy that provides a multinational forum to harness the collective expertise of maritime security practitioners and academia to generate outcome-oriented maritime thoughts. The event was hosted by Admiral Karambir Singh, who is the Chief of Naval Staff of the Indian Navy. The theme subject of the third GMC 2021 was Maritime Security and Emerging Non-Traditional Threats, a Case for Proactive Role for Indian Ocean Region Navies. One more thing here, Admiral Karambir Singh was the 24th Chief of Navy Staff. But now who is the 25th or the latest Chief of Navy Staff? He is Admiral R. Hari Kumar. Admiral R. Hari Kumar, sir. He is the new Chief of Navy Staff. Next, Indian Navy conducts security exercise Prasthan in western ODA of the Mumbai coast. Indian Navy conducted a security exercise called Prasthan in the offshore development area ODA of the coast of Mumbai. The exercise is conducted by the headquarters of Western Naval Command every 6 months. The exercise was conducted on the Mumbai High North platform of Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, located about 94 nautical miles off west of Mumbai. If we look at the objective, it is to ensure offshore security and integrate maritime stakeholders including the Navy, Air Force, Coast Guard, ONGC, Port Trust, Customs, State Fisheries Department and Maritime Police towards refining standard operating procedures for response to various contingencies that could occur in the ODA. Next, Union Minister Jitendra Singh has inaugurated world's most sophisticated MRI facility at NBRC. What is NBRC? NBRC stands for what? It is National Brain Research Center that is located in Manesar, Haryana. So our Union Minister for Science and Technology, that is Jitendra Singh, has launched the first of its kind, latest and world's most sophisticated magnetic resonance imaging, that is your MRI facility at National Brain Research Center, that is NBRC, in Manesar, Haryana. The new facility could reduce the scanning time for patients by almost a quarter from earlier generation machines by running intensive scanning modalities very fast. Moving on. Next, Jyoti Aditya Sikandia inaugurates curtain raiser event about Wings India 2022. On November 18th, Union Minister Jyotiraditya Madhavrao Sikandia, that is the Minister of Civil Aviation or the related ministry to this Wings India 2022 is Ministry of Civil Aviation, inaugurated a curtain raiser of the 5th edition of the Asia's largest event on civil aviation, namely Wings India 2022. Question can be asked, Wings India 2022 is inaugurated under which ministry? It is inaugurated under Ministry of Civil Aviation. Next, a 3-day Rashtra Raksha Sampann Parv. I repeat, a 3-day Rashtra Raksha Samarpan Parv was held in Jhansi, Uttar Pradesh. Now the question can be asked, recently, where Rashtra Raksha Samarpan Parv, where was this held? Where this Rashtra Raksha Samarpan Festival was held? It was held in Jhansi, Uttar Pradesh, another important market. Next comes your Boita Bandhana. Boita Bandhana. This festival is organized or celebrated by which state? Celebrated by Odisha. Boita Bandhana is a festival that is organized or celebrated by Odisha. If we look at it, on 19th of November, Kartika Purnima, which is also known as the Boita Bandhana, is celebrated at various water bodies of Odisha. People congregated in large numbers at sea beaches, river ghats and near other water bodies despite the restriction imposed on mass gatherings at public places by Bhuvaneshwar Municipal Corporation to prevent transmission of COVID-19. So, Boita Bandhana of Odisha and Rashtra Raksha Samarpan Parv of UP. Next, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh score high on Smart Police Perception Index and Bihar and UP were the lowest. So, in Smart Police Perception Index, the state that topped was of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh and the least were of Bihar and UP. Next, we'll be talking about BTS 2021. That is your Bangalore Tech Summit, important market. Bangalore Tech Summit held between 17th to 19th of November and the theme will be driving the next very important theme of 2021 BTS. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu inaugurated 24th edition of the Bengaluru Tech Summit, that is Asia's largest technology event that was conducted between 17th to 19th of November in the hybrid format. In this, for the first time, BTS hosted the United States Tech Conclave and the theme for this BTS will be driving the next. Southern Command of the Indian Army launched military exercise that says Dakshin Shakti. I repeat, the Southern Command of the Indian Army launched a military exercise that is Dakshin Shakti. Mark this, Dakshin Shakti. Where was this training areas? They were in Rajasthan and Gujarat to validate the battle readiness and operational effectiveness of troops of the Southern Army. Next, Coast Guards of India, Maldives and Sri Lanka. These are the three countries which together conducted a trilateral exercise that is Dosti. Very important, mark this. If asked, the countries, participating countries, name the participating countries of the exercise Dosti. They are India, Maldives and Sri Lanka. It was the 15th edition of this exercise of the Maldives, India and Sri Lanka, that is Dosti, and the location where this exercise was conducted is Maldives. Mark this. Alright, the year marks the 30th anniversary since the accession of this exercise. So what are the three regions? And it is to for the peaceful and safety of the Indian Ocean region basically. Alright, so the 15th edition of Dosti in which Maldives, India and Sri Lanka participated and the location of this exercise was Maldives. Next, Union Minister Bhupendra Yadav flags off first All India survey on domestic workers. Very important. The first All India survey on domestic workers were launched by which ministry? It was the or the person asked. If the ministry is asked, then the ministry is Ministry of Labour and Employment. And if the name of the person is Bhupendra Yadav. Alright. Next. Niti Aayog has launched India's first Sustainable Development Goal Urban Index for the year 21-22 in which the city that topped was Shimla. Niti Aayog launched the first Sustainable Development Goal Urban Index and Dashboard. It was launched by Dr. Rajiv Kumar, who is the Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog, and Professor Dr. Claudia Warning, who is the Director General of BMZ, that is the Federal Ministry for Economics, Corporation and Development of Germany. It is a sustainable development goal progress monitoring tool at the ULB, that is urban local body level. According to the index, 55 out of 56 urban areas assessed under sustainable development goal 2, that is zero hunger, have 25% anemia prevalence among women aged 15 to 49 years. During the launch event, a statement of intent was also signed between Niti Aayog and BMZ to promote cooperation between India and Germany. Under this statement of intent, Niti Aayog and BMZ dialogue on the development of cooperation will be established for periodic bilateral discussions. Next, India and Indonesian Navy holds the 37th edition of the Coordinated Patrol. Very important, market. Coordinated or CORPET, this is also known as CORPET. So this CORPET, the 37th edition of the CORPET was held between India and Indonesian Navy. Very important, market. Alright, question can be asked that 37th edition of the CORPET was between India and Indonesian Navy. Mark this, very important. If asked from Indian side, it was INS Khanjar that took part. And of Indian naval ship, KRI Sultan Taha Saifuddin took part in this exercise. Most important is Indian that you should know, because generally it is asked that which Indian ship or which INS took part in the CORPET or 37th edition of CORPET that is held between India and Thailand. It is INS Khanjar. Next, foundation stone of India's first zero emission airport laid by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, where in Uttar Pradesh, in Jewar, Uttar Pradesh, the foundation stone of India's first zero emission airport was laid down. All right. Narendra Modi ji laid the foundation stone of the Noida International Airport, that is NIA, or the JR Airport at Jewar, Uttar Pradesh. This airport is planned in 1334 hectares in the Yamuna Express International Development Authority notified area of the district Gautam Buddha Nagar, UP. The airport is being developed by concessionaries Yamuna International Airport Private Limited. Coming back, you should just know this is the first net zero emission airport located in UP. Noida International Airport, it's the name, or the Jewar Airport of Jewar is the name. You should know this. Then if we talk about UP, there are few airports you can see here. Heritage sites are Agra Fort, Taj Mahal and Fatehpur Sikri. And if we are talking about bird sanctuary, Nawabganj Bird Sanctuary, Sandy Bird Sanctuary and Samaspur Bird Sanctuary are the sanctuaries in UP. Next, India's first or the first ever Arabal festival held in Kulgam, Jammu and Kashmir. So in the Kulgam district of Jammu and Kashmir, Arabal festivals was held for the first time and it is to promote tourism. Arabal is then because it is related, or you can say it is a type of a Arabal is a waterfall in Jammu and Kashmir. It is known as the, you can say, Niagara Fall of Kashmir, Arabal Falls. So that is the reason to attract tourism or to promote tourism in Jammu and Kashmir. This Arabal festival was held for the first time. Next, Meghalaya inaugurated Cherry Blossom Festival in Shillong. In Meghalaya, Shillong, Meghalaya's inaugurated Cherry Blossom Festival in Shillong. Question can be asked, very important. Shillong Cherry Blossom Festival, inaugurated by the Chief Minister of Meghalaya, Conrad K. Sagma, and Ambassador of Japan to India, Saitoshi Suzuki. It started from 25th to 27th November, and the festival is held in two venues, Wards Lake and Polo Ground in Meghalaya. So question can be asked, where is the Cherry Blossom Festival? It is of which state? It is of Meghalaya. Next, DTO launched on Delhi's Metro Pink Line. DMRC becomes world's fourth biggest metro railway network. So Pink Line is the, you can say, here it is written out, DMRC become the world's fourth biggest metro rail network. Which is it? It is the Delhi Metro Rail Network, that or Rail Corporation, that became the, that is DTO or DMRC, that becomes the fourth largest biggest metro rail network. One more thing, Pink Line becomes the second metro corridor in New Delhi to have the driverless operations. Niti Aayog's first national MPI 2021. Kerala has the lowest poverty while Bihar has the highest. What is your MPI? MPI stands for Multidimensional Poverty Index. So Niti Aayog has released the first national Multidimensional Poverty Index, in which Bihar and Jharkhand and UP ranked as the poorest state in India. On the other hand, Kerala has the lowest poverty across India, that is around 0.71% only. If we talk about Niti Aayog, Niti Aayog was established on January 1st, 2015. Before this, it was known as Planning Commission. The chairman of Niti Aayog is the current Prime Minister of India, and CEO is Amitabh Kant. Headquarters is in New Delhi. And this National Multidimensional Poverty Index is released by Niti Aayog, and it was the first edition that was released for the first time. Next, first Indian city to start ropeway service as a mode of public transport. It is your Varanasi. State asked, it is UP. Varanasi, a city of Uttar Pradesh, is set to become the first Indian city to start ropeway service as a mode of public transport in order to ease the traffic congestion. The proposed railway will be constructed between Kent Railway Station to Church Square, covering an aerial distance of 3.45 kilometers. Next, Next, you should know is the world's tallest railway bridges, world's largest railway pier bridge to come up in Manipur, and it is located on Ijai River. Mark this also. This is an important question, can be asked indirectly, that world's tallest railway bridge is located in which city or which state? It is in Manipur, but it is located on which river? It is located on Ijai River.
Hello friends, through our recent general aware section analysis, we have identified that the news related to mega events is finding more weightage in the competitive exams. In order to cover related news to mega events such as Olympics, national awards, cabinet appointments, all of which contain heavy information, we have chosen a different way to convey that information using interactive infographics. Here is an example of interactive infographics. Using this, you can choose to study various information just from the single PDF. If you want to talk about the medal tally of Tokyo Olympic Games, just by clicking on the image of medals, you'll be able to see the information related to medals. Now, if you want to study about any of the players mentioned here, just by clicking on the image of that particular player, you will be getting the information related to that particular player.
Now, you will be provided with two types of PDFs. One is your desktop version and second is your mobile version. As the name suggests, desktop version is for both PCs, laptops, and your mobile version is basically for the mobile phones and tablets. In order to use your desktop version in mobile phone, you can use the software of WAPS application in your Google Play, and you can access the desktop version of the file in the phones also. So friends, this format of presentation will help you to remember all the valuable information in an easy manner by connecting information to the related images. Our team has worked immensely hard to bring this to you, and so please do share your valuable suggestions and feedback through comments, as it will boost us to create further such initiatives. Thank you.
तो फ्रेंड्स, ये थी हमारी वीडियो। अगर आपको आज हमारी वीडियो से कुछ ना कुछ सीखने को मिला है, तो जल्दी से जाइए और हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर दें और इस वीडियो को लाइक कर दें। और फ्रेंड्स, अगर आपको हमारे कंटेंट से रिलेटेड या फिर हमारी कोई ऐप से इशू आ रहा है, कोई भी आपको प्रॉब्लम है, तो आप हमारी जीमेल आईडी जो कि है support@affairscloud.com या फिर हमारा नंबर 9677333862 पर कांटेक्ट कर सकते हैं, एंड हमारी टीम जल्दी से जल्दी आपके इशू को रिजॉल्व करने में आपकी सहायता करेगी। सो टेक केयर।